posting this meeting?
Yes, we did.
Okay, thank you very much. At this time, if y'all please rise, I'm going to ask you, Mr. Satter, if you'll lead us an invocation, and then we'll remain standing for our pledges.
Let us pray. Our most precious Heavenly Father, dear Lord, we just thank you for allowing us to come together and meet this morning. Dear Lord, we just pray that you watch over us and let us conduct this meeting that is in a manner that is pleasing to thee. Dear Lord, we just pray that you continue to watch over our law enforcement and force responders, and we pray for their safety. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible.
Okay, I'd like to welcome everyone to our meeting today. Let the record show that all the commissioners are present. At this time, we will entertain citizens' comments, and we do have a person that would like to speak to us. I want to make sure that you do understand that this time is almost a time of rudeness on our part. We can listen to you, but we aren't able to respond to you. Please don't take it as being rude. It's just that's the way we do it. We'll give you around 3 minutes. We're not going to hold you exactly to that, close to it. And so at this time, I'll ask, is it Mr. Potts, Doug Potts?
Yes, sir.
Come on up, sir.
Come on, Judge.
Come on.
Just want to address the last meeting. There was a statement made about the ARPA funds that, and I just want to clarify that statement, that they were not tax dollars. I would like to contradict that, that they are in fact tax dollars, just not directly paid or collected by Limestone County, but they are collected by federal tax dollars, which all of us pretty much are taxpayers. So anyway, just when it came out in the paper, I kind of looked at that. It gave me a little heartburn. Just wanted to, you know, maybe have the court recognize that they are tax dollars. And as tax dollars, there was a debate in that meeting that there was $200,000 of that left that was being debated, or a motion was made that didn't carry, to divide that amongst some of the water companies, SLC and whatever, that didn't pass. As a taxpayer, I fundamentally have heartburn about giving tax dollars to private for-profit entities. I think that money would be better spent going into infrastructure, road and bridge. We know our county roads are bad. Or even if it's allowable, put that $200,000 towards the senior citizens center, add it to that $80,000, roughly $80,000, and do something with that. So that was really all I had to say. Thank you for your time.
Thank you for bringing that up. And let me just say this. I would love to visit with you. If you ever have time, or after the meeting, if you have time, I'd love to visit with you about some of that. And I will just go on record as saying, although we're not supposed to really respond, we're not that big of an organization, we can't do a little bit. I said that it's not tax dollars. And I realize that it is tax dollars. I guess what I should have said is not local ad valorem tax dollars. And that would have been a better statement. So thank you for bringing that up.
Thank you, Judge.
All right. Anybody else? Okay, let's keep going then. Item number six is our consent agenda. I hope that y'all had a chance to take a look at that. What's your pleasure on this?
So moved.
Got a motion?
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion on that item? If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Anybody opposed? We'll go ahead and pass that. As it's raining outside, we're going to talk about the burn ban. I don't know if we need to take any action. Matt, do you recommend taking any action on this burn ban?
No, you can put it on the video. No. Not necessary.
We won't take any action then. Let's go ahead then and go to item number eight. And that's going to be discussing and take action advertising a bid for a covered warm-up area for Limestone County Fairgrounds. One of the things that we did talk about at our meeting is spending some of that money to improve the show barn. We do have a bid here. I just need to make it official that we actually go out for bid for this covered arena.
I make a motion that we put the covered arena out for bid.
Second.
Motion and second. Any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, that'll pass. Well, let's keep going then. Next item is also an item about the show barn, and that's discuss take action on the sale of roping boxes from Limestone County Fairground. Tiffany's not here, but I know whenever she originally presented the her report last time, one of the
requested that she could sell and replace the roping boxes. I told her because it was not on the agenda that we probably needed to, it wasn't specifically talked about. I don't have a problem with her putting that on the Limestone County webpage and selling those old ones. I know she's already bought the new ones, but I'll leave that up to y'all. But what's your pleasure on that?
I move that we approve the sale of the roping boxes from the Limestone County Fairgrounds.
Second.
Motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? And that'll pass. All right. Let's go to item number 10. Let's discuss take action on leaving blocks 47, lots 9 and 10 to the city of Posse. This is, I know that y'all had a chance to look at the quick claim deed. Is there any discussion on this?
I move we approve deeding block 47, lots 9 and 10 to CASA.
I'll second that.
Motion and a second. We'll once again ask for any discussion. If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Now then, source of it. Discuss and take action on purchasing generators from American Rescue Plan, the ARPA funds. This is something that we have agreed that we wanted to buy at least two generators to help prevent what happened to us in a couple of years ago. Paul, tell us what exactly happened on this. I know you were taking over this.
Okay. What happened, on my board, there was an advertised price for these generators, and that's what we were going by. After it was approved, I got in touch with Clifford Power regarding their price, and they, I've got a copy of the email here, says that they had submitted new prices to Byboard. Byboard had just not updated it. They came back with a quote that the original Byboard price was basically $98,500 a piece. The actual price is almost $115,000 a piece.
So about $16,000 more?
Yes.
So $32,000 total?
Basically, the new price is including freight, whereas the old one didn't, but you're only talking $1,000 or $2,000 there. That's what happened. If y'all want a copy of the email, I can give it to you, but that's where we're at.
Of course, in all fairness, as Paul knows, or I made some phone calls on this, like I do, and one saying they did it, one saying they never got it. There's nobody else on buy board that has these generators at this price.
Not that I've found.
And the generators that I've found out there in the private world, I'm not sure it would benefit us just to go out for a regular bid, but I haven't found anything that's cheap on all the generators that I've looked for throughout. So what do you do? I'm just glad they didn't say, hey, it's another $50,000 each, you know. But at that point, I think we would have gone out for bids because there are some that are around 100 and a half.
So time we take the freight out and adjust off, it's about $30,000 more for two generators than it would have been if we'd bought them last year.
Yes.
I move we go ahead and purchase the generators out of the American Rescue.
Okay. Have a motion?
I second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? No. All right, item number 12 is the receive for record the racial profiling report for Limestone County Sheriff's Office in Constable Precinct 3. This is something that we do every year. I know that the constables and the sheriff's department, Murray, do you have anything to say on this? This is
pretty. I didn't bring a copy with me this morning. Okay.
Anyway, bottom line is this is the report that we send in each year. So y'all want to approve it from the Sheriff's Department in Precinct 3. We've got it ready for you today.
Make a motion to receive the racial profile report from Precinct 3.
I'll second that.
Motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Next item is we're going to take take action on an agreement with the Tri-County Family Medical Care Group. That's the urgent care there in Mahia. For the 5 years, 4.5 years I've been here, we've never done this. So I found out why do we need to do this. Murray, do you want to address it? Tell us what it's about. I know what it's about now, but you want to address it?
On the drug testing?
Yeah. And in all fairness, this is just them now putting a legal contract with us. Nothing binding as far as saying we have to use so many. Again, the price is not
correct. We never had a contract something like that before. I think that's in some of their changes that they're doing.
Okay.
Going case by case, we call them and send somebody up.
I'd like to change it. Maybe table this to look into other avenues.
Is that a motion?
That's a motion.
All right.
Put another provider.
A motion to table this item?
If, go ahead.
Hang on, let's see if we get a second.
Second.
Okay, we do have a motion and a second. Now let's start the discussion.
Contracting with them doesn't stop us from going somewhere else.
Not to my knowledge.
It's just, if we're going to do anything with them, we got to have a contract.
Correct.
Exactly.
I mean, we can table it, but we're not, I mean, we can still look other places.
It's not binding to have to use
no,
them.
No, we're not binding to use them.
Okay.
And I mean, and we're not obligating ourselves to any certain.
So it's just not locking us exclusively into them, correct?
That's right.
Okay.
That's
my understanding. Yeah. A good example would be that if we want to start using the local hospital here, if you want to start using the hospital there in Mahia, or even a service that might want to come through, this does not bind.
They're small enough to bring in. It's fine.
Let's go ahead and take care of the motion and the second.
Judge, wait before we close the discussion.
All
right. Like Jerry said, he sends his people to Limestone County Medical.
Okay.
And it may be that Jerry needs to look in and see if it's cheaper at Tahoe. I mean, we just
right.
use,
Absolutely.
It's almost like taking bids from flat stationers and Rimco for
right.
supply.
Right.
We go to where we can get it to
right.
bed.
So since we're doing a contract with them, they have contracted pricing, I assume?
I believe so. And
or is it
with
sliding
their changes,
scale?
That's where the contract's coming
yeah.
from, in my understanding.
Basically, if you read this, it's just a whole lot about HIPAA
yeah.
Laws in here that they want to make sure that we're...
If we're going to send anything in there, we've got to have a contract.
Correct.
And a lot of that's to do with their expansion and changing their name.
And one of the reasons we first began using them was the turnaround time was almost immediately. They did their own testing. They didn't have to send stuff out. So we didn't have to have people come in, do an interview, start the hiring process, go, wait for results, then come back and keep going through.
Okay, we do have a motion and a second. Let's go ahead and vote if we want to table this. Is what the motion was? All in favor say aye. Any opposed?
No.
Okay, we vote nay not to table it.
Not to table.
Not nay. Yeah.
Nay.
Yeah.
Nay.
Yeah.
Nay. Not to table.
Nay is what I would vote.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So let's go ahead then and go back to this contract. Do we want to sign this contract to do business with? The urgent care folks there, Taos Urgent Care.
I make a motion that we do business with the TRICARE Medical, Family Medical Cares Group.
Okay. Is a motion?
I'll second that.
And a second. Any other discussion on this? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All righty. Let's go to item number 14, and that's going to be a budget amendment transfer. This is 595. This is going to be from the road and bridge. This is to cover the cost of two new trucks that we're buying. Moving the money out of the road equipment over to the road vehicles.
Make a motion that we approve the budget transfer from road equipment to road vehicles.
Second.
Motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? That'll pass. Item number 15 is discuss take action on transfer of finances for Limestone County Fairgrounds. There's quite a few items here, but transfer of the funds to cover the salary of the new position that we started out there. We're taking the money, we're increasing it for the salaries, and then we're also taking it out of the contingencies for that amount this year. What's the pleasure of the court?
I make a motion that we approve the budget transfer for the fairgrounds from contingencies to the salaries line.
A second.
Motion and a second. Any other discussion on this item? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Nay.
One and nay. Okay. Let's go to item number 16 then and discuss take action on new revenue from the acceptance of the American Rescue Plan Act. Natasha, is this something you wanted on here?
Yes. This is based on the last meeting when y'all were discussing the different areas of where you were wanting to spend the money. This is now putting the money into the budget. So I put it in the revenue and the expense line. I just did based on the items that y'all had approved, the broadband, the, for the grant works, the purchase of the two generators, and I did change it to match the new price because I had gotten that in time before I gave you the copies. Also the amount to help with the replacement on the new jail security system.
$350.
The $350, and then $150 for the, to go towards the warm-up arena. So this is just getting it into the new, into this year's budget.
Yes.
Based on just what y'all discussed last meeting.
And there's still about $250 left.
There will be...
Well, it won't be $250 anymore.
No, it's
$230.
Be about $200.
Yes.
$200.
It's about $300, actually.
Yeah, I would say.
And we'll talk a future date of what we might do with that.
Yes, because we don't have to decide today what we
no.
do.
No.
We have to do in 2025.
Okay.
That's going to leave, with those changes, $334,000.
Okay. And that's with the new price on the generator?
Yes.
I didn't hear you mention the $85,000 for the...
That's not in here because when y'all were discussing it at the last meeting, y'all did not say definitely about that. Y'all had agreed on all the other items.
For the senior citizens.
Correct.
But as long as that's still in, we still have
there's,
the money.
There's still money, but I just did for
that,
the items that y'all specifically.
So
Mr. Sadler, we still haven't found anything, correct?
No, we're still working on trying.
So we can leave it like it is.
Yeah, just when at that point in time, because with the way things are and the timing and everything, who knows, it may be next budget year.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just trying to do the items that you're specifically agreed upon as you agree upon them to get them into the...
So with the $85,000 set aside for the senior citizens,
yeah,
would that come out of the 334?
No. Yes.
It would come out.
Yes.
Okay.
What's the pleasure of the court on as far as transferring this money?
So moved.
Got a motion?
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? And item number 17, adjournment. Anybody want to adjourn?
So moved.
Okay.
Hey, wait a minute, you can't. That's my thing.
Yeah.